So something very important that you need to remember when you're doing a challenge such as this is your water intake. And we touched on water before, but I'd like to dig a little bit deeper into water today, right? And this is going to be true for whether you're on a challenge or you're not on a challenge. You need to drink adequate amount of water. So water is 60% of the male's body, right? 60% of the male's body is made up of water. And 55% of the female body is made up of water. So that's a huge part. More than half of your body is water. What does this mean? It means that you have to make sure there's enough water in your system, because if so much of your body is water, then when you don't have enough water in your system to sustain it, what do you think will happen? I'm pretty sure a lot of things go on inside your body when your body is running low of water. So you should be trying to make sure you have adequate amount of water in your system. Your skin, which is considered their largest organ, is 64% water. Your brain is 73% water. Think about that. 73% of your brain is water. Do you see why you get a headache easily when you're dehydrated? Because if your brain has so much water in it and you're running low on water, then it's going to affect your brain. It's going to affect your brain. And if your brain is affected, then your entire body will be affected. You know, the message will go out. Something is going pretty bad here. We need water. We need water. We need water, right? Restore, restore, restore. So if your brain is 73% water, it means that it needs water to function properly, because that's almost three quarters of your brain is water. So how serious is that? It is very serious. I consider that to be very, very serious, that 73% of your brain is water. So you have to have enough fluid in your body to sustain your brain properly, all right? Your heart is 73% water. 73% of your heart is water. So between your heart and your brain requires so much water. How can you afford not to have enough water in your system? You shouldn't let your system run out of water, like run low. I think if you run out, you'll die. But I'm talking about running low, right? You should make sure that your body has enough water to sustain your brain and your heart adequately. And as soon as it starts to get low on these, you're going to have all kind of signals and messages going around in your system saying, we are out there running low, right? All right, so your lungs is 83% water. How about that? That's more than three quarters, 83%. Let that sink in. So can you imagine your brain, your heart, your lungs, what a pandemonium they go into when your water levels get low? Can you imagine? We have to sustain our body with adequate amount of water or fluids, right? Good fluids, not bad ones. All right, and then muscles and kidneys, 79. So you see how high these numbers are, 79%? Your muscles and your kidney. So if your muscles and kidney are 79%. Your brain and your heart are 73, and your lungs is 83. You see how significant water is to your body? You can't afford to let your body run low on water. Really, you can't. No wonder you get old and look old fast when you're not hydrating properly. Your body needs water to sustain it. Good amount of water too. All right, your bones. They need water too, your bones. Imagine that. Your 31%. They might look like, oh, it's bones, they're tough and dry, whatever. No, but they need water too. Even your bones need water. A whole 31% of it is water. Okay? So we should not take this for granted. Plasma, the liquid portion of your blood, it's 90% water. Plasma in your blood, the liquid section of your blood is 90% water. We can't play with that. We have to do better with our water drinking, right? The plasma in your blood helps carry your blood cells, nutrients, and hormones. So you can't play with that. You cannot play with that. There's no water. Then the plasma can't do carrying these things around to the different parts of your body. So, you know, you realize how many things can go bad in your body when you're not getting enough water. Realize how much things the plasma can't carry. These things are on your body, right? Because it's dry. What is it going to do? So we do need to have adequate amount of water for all sorts of functions in your body. 2/3 of the body's water is in the cell. All right. So the percentage of water that you need depends on several factors, right? Some of these factors include your weight, your size, your height, right? How active you are, how much time you spend outside in harsh environment, if you work outside or inside, you know, because the evaporation from your skin will be determined based on whether you're indoors or outdoors and how active you are, right? So the amount of water that one person needs is not the same as another person, because it's based on, you know, your activities and what kind of body you have, how big you are, how small you are. These are factors in how much water you really need per day. There is a simple formula. I know most people know of drinking 8 ounce glasses of water per day. But there's a simple formula that you can use to determine how much water you need based on your body size. And the formula goes like this. You divide your weight into pounds. You divide your weight in pounds by 2. So if you're 200 pounds, you divide it by 2, which would be 100, right? And drink that amount in ounces. So you're 200 pounds. So it is 200 divided by 2, which is 100. Very simple. And you're going to be drinking 100 ounces of water per day. Right? 100 ounces of water per day. So it's very simple to do. Divide your weight by 2, and whatever it comes to, that amount of ounces you're going to drink every day. All right? Coffee, tea, or certain sodas can have diuretic effects. So these are things you need to consider when you're drinking fluids. If you're drinking coffee or tea and some other kinds of drinks, that sodas, they may have diuretic effects. And what that means is they send you to the bathroom more frequently. So you need to take into consideration what you're drinking, because you're losing fluid also by going to the bathroom frequently. So you want to weigh how much of these fluids you drink per day, right? And when you're going to the bathroom that frequently, you need to take into consideration, it's a good thing to go to the bathroom frequently, but you need to take into consideration how much water you're pushing out of your system each time you go to the bathroom, and are you replacing it, right? So you want to be careful about how much of these things you're drinking and how often you are replacing the fluid that you're losing. Okay. All right. So things that are diuretic, you want to control how much of that you take in, unless you're replenishing your water levels, right? Remember that caffeine will make you want to go. Caffeine will always send you to the bathroom. There are things like some liquor, some beers, and all these things, they send you to the bathroom a lot. So be careful how much of those things you drink when you drink them, and make sure you are drinking water as well. Let's look at some foods that have lots of water. So things like strawberries or any berries, they usually have good water content. Citrus fruits, obviously, because when you eat an orange or grapefruit or one of those tangerine or so, you're squeezing a lot of times the juice from it. And so that means it has a lot of water in it. That's the water, and whatever nutrients comes out of the fruit all go together to make the juice from the fruit, right? But maybe the thing that is most in it is water. All right. And lettuce has a lot of water too. Lettuce, especially like iceberg lettuce and some of these, they're mostly water. And cucumber has a high water content as well. Spinach has high water content. Melons, cantaloupes, all of those, they have high water content. So in the event that you are somewhere that you don't have a lot of water to drink, and you have access to these fruits, you can drink them and you would be helping to hydrate your body, although not as much as you would if you were drinking a lot of water. But especially things like watermelon, they do deliver a lot of water, and the melons. All right, so if you do eat a lot of those things, take it into consideration that you're also putting a good amount of water in your body, depending on how much you eat, right? You may or may not need to drink the same amount of water if you are drinking a lot of, or if you're eating a lot of oranges, or a lot of watermelons and so on, because that also helps to hydrate your body. What are the signs of being dehydrated? For a lot of us, being dehydrated means your mouth gets dry, your lips get a little bit chopped or parched, right? And you get fatigue. You get dark urine when you go to the bathroom. It's not clear. Your urine should be clear, like really, really clear. That's when you know you have a lot of water in your system. But when you see your urine has that darkish, yellowish, goldish color, you know that you don't have enough water. That's a good telltale sign. Or you just have a little bit of urine, it might be that you need to be hydrated better. So when you're not urinating, you may not be having enough water. So the dry mouth, the dizziness, confusion sometimes can be caused from dehydration. What are the risks of dehydration. You could get a heat stroke if you're in an environment where the weather is really harsh. There's a lot of sun and heat. You could literally get a heat stroke if you're dehydrated. You could get a urinary tract infection. Kidney stone also is said that that was one of the things you could get by not being hydrated. You could, in extreme circumstances, get into a seizure, right? A seizure can be brought on by heat exhaustion and a sudden drop in your blood pressure. So look out for those things, right? Look out for those things. Your blood pressure could drop because you're dehydrated. Can you drink too much water? One might ask. And the simple answer is yes, you could drink too much water. There's such a thing as water intoxication, or I heard another term being used called drowning. You can overdo water. So you have to also be cognizant of that. Do all things in moderation. And it means all things, right? So try to stick with the amount of water that you're supposed to drink, and be mindful of the other ways that you might be taking water in your system. And also be aware that if you're pregnant, you will need more water than normal, because you're drinking water for 2 or 3, depending on whether you have a pair of twins. All right, so be mindful of that, and also be mindful of what level of activity you do daily that would cause you to lower or heighten your water intake. So those are things to always keep in the back of your head, right, when you're determining how much water you're drinking. So water intoxication, this is a condition where levels of sodium, potassium, and other electrolytes become diluted. And they become diluted because there's too much water going through your system, and it literally washes out the nutrients that you're putting in. So you don't want that to happen. So don't over hydrate, right? Too much of one thing is good for nothing, they always say. So you need a lot of water for sure, but there is a limit. So don't overdo it. Try to find out what's the correct amount. Remember, we said half your body weight, right, in ounces. So that's a simple thing to remember, half your body weight in ounces. And if you're pregnant, you may need more. If you're working, like you're a construction worker, or you're a farmer, or somebody who's outside a lot, doing a lot, if you're like a cyclist, if you're an athlete in any way, and you are using, not sweating a lot, you might need more water than the normal person, right? But the standard is half your body weight in ounces. All right, so if anyone has any comments or question about this presentation and you want more information, you could get in touch with me. It's easy to find me on social media, or you could comment on this video wherever you see it, and I will see it, even if not the same time, I will see it eventually. All right, and so for those of you who need to follow up with your fasting, or with just getting more information about our wellness program, you can also contact me. You can go straight to my website and schedule an appointment with me at ivmaclilly.com. You could schedule a free consultation with me, and we could take it from there, right? We could take it from there. Remember, like I said before, I do have a coaching program. I have a 4-month program that you can discuss with me when you get in touch with me. And I'd like to also tell you that I do have beautiful, great tasting herbs and spices. but mainly herbs, right? Herbal teas. And you can also find those at my website at ifmaclele.com. If you go to the shop section, you will see these. And also castor oil, Jamaican black castor oil, both the cold press version and the regular black castor oil. You can get these from off my website as well. So don't be afraid to get in touch with me, right? I'm here to serve. So message me whenever you need to arrange an appointment, or go straight to my website at ifmaclele.com. On the first landing page at ifmaclele.com, you would see a button there to schedule a free consultation, right? Or just email me. All right. Have a blessed day, guys. And we'll be in touch. Thank you for watching. Thank you for sharing. Bye-bye.